The Victoria Guitar Trio is made up of three best friends, really, and we've known each other for so long, and we've played all this complex classical music to play something a little bit looser and something that more personal to us. The opportunity to combine that with the kind of avant-garde classical scene and those and the compositions that we play is an opportunity for us, both as musicians and friends, to collaborate in a new way, and it's a very exciting kind of way to perform.
Melos Dianoia is a movement of a larger seven-movement piece. The seven movements all are inspired by Aristotle's ideas about drama, and one of those important ideas is melody and tunefulness. Aristotle actually thought that through tunefulness and melody, the soul can be changed. I teach all my students the blues. I love playing the blues. That's one music you can go anywhere in the world with a guitar, and everyone knows how to play the 12-bar blues. So Melos definitely touches on that sort of nostalgic part of playing the guitar and being a guitarist. And I think that's one of Scott's strengths, is that he saw that and wasn't afraid to quote something so obvious.
The piece is notated in a way which, on first glance, looks fairly complex and is actually quite a challenge for the ensemble. But the end effect is one which sounds very loose and actually, in some sections, even improvised. It's a very effective writing in that the composer was able to retain some elements of the blues style and the improvisatory quality while creating a very challenging piece for the ensemble.
So that idea that the score is complex and yet the music sounds so natural and almost improvised was a real challenge for us, but also a real interesting musical experience.
And the first guitar part is playing a slide guitar melody, which is actually a reference to an earlier blues pioneer, Blind Willie Johnson. The music was later reset by Ry Cooder and featured prominently in Paris, Texas, the movie.
The original quotation is used as the jumping off point for a dialogue between the three guitars. So we have the very tuneful Adrian on the slide guitar and Brad and myself enshrining Adrian in a cloud of harmonics and bass notes.
Normally the slide is not used as a traditional way of playing classical guitar, and just the sound of a slide evokes blues music. As a result, it immerses the listener in very coloristic sounds that are not usually found on classical guitar recordings.